You can literally die from a broken heart. It's called broken heart syndrome, and if that wasn't depressing enough for you, if you're a female, it's more likely to happen to you. But all is not lost. I know Valentine's Day is quickly approaching, and the way I started this video is probably not the most uplifting thing you've heard in your entire life, but if you stick with me, we will end on a positive note, and you'll have learned something pretty cool along the way, or at least that's my hope. So lovebirds, let's do this. So first of all, broken heart syndrome really isn't the best name for it. It's more properly known as Takotsubo cardiomyopathy, which is Japanese for heart muscle problem that looks like an octopus trap. And you're probably already sitting there like, what? The thing is though, it's actually a pretty good name because the heart balloons out and it does in fact look like the pot that's used to catch octopus. In order to figure out what's going wrong here, let's first orient ourselves with the heart itself. So the first thing you're gonna notice is that we've made a few incisions, and that's so we can see inside to more effectively and properly teach. But you are looking at an anterior view or the front of the heart, and then this would be a posterior view or the backside of the heart. Now, the heart is more or less divided into half. There's a right deoxygenated half and a left oxygenated half. But within those two halves, there are two chambers. So you have four total chambers. And the first chamber we can see is right here called the right atrium. And this is going to collect deoxygenated blood and it's going to send it through this valve, which you can kind of see a bit right there, kind of get this out of the way, called the tricuspid valve. And we are now inside of the right ventricle. The right ventricle will then contract and send it through this blood vessel that we have cut. So if I could connect that, that would be one singular blood vessel called the pulmonary trunk. And it's gonna send that deoxygenated blood to the lungs. Makes perfect sense, right? You gotta get oxygen. The lungs are then gonna send the blood back, freshly oxygenated, into this chamber here called the left atrium. The left atrium will then send the blood through another valve, which you can see a bit right here called the mitral valve or the bicuspid valve into this gigantic chamber here called the left ventricle. Much more massive, much stronger, much larger. The left ventricle will then contract and send the blood out this gigantic blood vessel here called the aorta. And it is massive. It's the size of a garden hose, pretty big. And that will then distribute the oxygenated blood to the rest of the body. But we also need to focus because we're gonna be spending most of our time talking about the left ventricle here. This point is called the apex of the heart. And then the apex, oh, well then besides the apex, you're also gonna have this upper portion called the base of the left ventricle. And both of those are gonna play an extremely important role with Takotsubo cardiomyopathy or broken heart syndrome. So what's happening with broken heart syndrome then? You actually don't know. That's because the exact pathophysiology is still currently unknown. But what we do know is that the patient usually suffers from some kind of emotional trauma beforehand. So you can go ahead and fill in the blank here. Maybe the IRS contacts you for an immense amount of back taxes. Maybe you lose your job. Maybe you lose a loved one, so on and so forth. But besides this emotional trauma, we do find the presence of something called catecholamines. And these are gonna be things like epinephrine and norepinephrine, which you probably know better as adrenaline. And this should make perfect sense to you, right? So if you're experiencing an emotional trauma, your heart's gonna start beating like crazy, right? Those adrenaline levels are gonna spike. And it could actually be that the spike in adrenaline and the presence of all these catecholamines are what cause Takotsubo cardiomyopathy. The reason why some think that is because we see elevated levels of catecholamines in other heart conditions. So it kind of seems plausible that too much adrenaline could literally cause you or your heart to break. But at the same time, we do have other theories out there. And if I were to place my bet, it would be that there are multiple things all happening at once. It's not just gonna be the presence of adrenaline. So regardless of what causes it, what's happening to the heart, or at least to this pointed portion called the apex, is that it balloons out. But not only does it balloon out, this upper portion of the left ventricle that I'm touching with my index fingers here, it's called the base, is going to contract. So if you have this contracture and this ballooning at the same time, that's what gives that typical octopus trap shape. The problem with this, besides the fact that the heart is literally getting bigger, is that when the apex balloons out, it's no longer going to be able to contract effectively, meaning it's not going to be able to eject an adequate amount of blood out the aorta to be able to get delivered to the rest of the body. Remember, this blood is oxygenated, and that's literally what your entire body runs off of. This is why it can be so difficult to properly diagnose broken heart syndrome in its earliest stages, and that's because the symptoms are so closely aligned with other types of heart conditions, such as a heart attack. You're going to experience chest pain and shortness of breath, for instance. And that means the only way to properly diagnose whether you have a heart attack or some other heart failure or Takotsubo cardiomyopathy is to do tests such as an ECG, an echocardiogram, an angiogram, or an MRI. Now you may be wondering, Justin, why does it affect females more than males? That's very strange. And to you, I would say that's a good question that we don't have an answer for. But it's even more than that. Not only does it affect females more than males, it affects postmenopausal females more so. And we also don't know why. So I can see you right now saying, hey, Justin, you said we're gonna end on a good note. And you're right. I did. You ready for some fantastic news? You're not all that likely to die from it. Most patients fully recover unless they have some other underlying condition. That's because it has a fantastic prognosis when you compare it to other heart conditions such as a heart attack or other types of heart failure. And in fact, the left ventricle more or less will return to normal after a few months of rest and some medications such as beta blockers. So yes, it may be possible to die from a broken heart, but it's not all that probable. So that sounds like some good news to me. Thanks for watching, everybody. I really hope you enjoyed this one. As always, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell. That way you can be the first person to see all of our content as it comes out. But as always, I will see you in the next video.